In this section, we'll be talking about working with video and working with animation. It's basically the same thing inside of Photoshop as far as Photoshop is concerned. And in both cases, we'll be working with the animation timeline. So let's just go ahead and bring that up first, animation, and bring it across the bottom right down there. There we go. And I'll adjust our view here to fit on screen. There it is. Let's just review the two different ways of bringing animation into a document. First, go over to File and Import Video Frames to Layers. This brings in each frame of video as a separate layer. So that's our first way. Click on that one. Inside the Pictures folder, we have this little Bubbles AVI file. Choose Load. In here, you can choose to bring from the beginning to end or only a selected range. Limit to every certain number of frames. It'll skip frame if you want to, and then make a frame animation out of that. Let's just set our range. I'll find the beginning position right there. I think in there is pretty good. Hold the Shift key down and then find your end position right there. So we'll bring in that bit of video. Choose OK. And it's going to go through and do that process of bringing each video frame in. Now once that's finished, notice at the bottom we now have in the animation panel, we have every single frame of video in here inside of our animation panel. I can actually scroll through and look at all of those frames of video just like this. It's all here on the animation. Also notice the time in there. It holds that frame for 0.03 of a second. That just matches the rate that the video played at, so it's automatically matched the frame rate as well. You can adjust that frame rate if you want to. Click on that little button there and actually choose a different frame rate in there, but I'll leave ours at the default. We can choose to loop that in here. You can have some options on there to how you want it to loop it. You can go back to the first video. You can move forward a frame at a time, move backwards a frame at a time, just like that. We can play the video. Click on the play button. It will then play through that video frame. And you can watch the effect of that video playing just like that. With that slight delay held in there. It will go clear back through the end. And then depending on your settings, it will repeat again if you had it set to repeat. If we look at our layers, you'll see here that this is all in as separate layers. Each frame of video has come in as a separate layer. So that's the first way to get video into your file. The second way, and we'll do a new file here. I'm going to rename this one first. Let's just rename this one. I'll call this one video-layers. There we go. The second way, we'll do a file new, and we'll set this at the default Photoshop size. There we go. Is to create a video layer. Layer menu, video layers right down here. New video layer from file. Click on that. And in the pictures folder again, there it is, bubbles.avi. Choose open. And this brings the video in as a layer. And notice that the timeline has changed. We have a different kind of timeline down here now. So there are two kinds of timelines depending upon the kind of layer that you're working with. The first timeline in here, this is an animation timeline, and this has each layer is used as an animation. So obviously with an animation timeline, I could put anything I want to in here as individual frames and then use that to create an animation. We'll be doing that in the next, actually a couple of discussions from now. We'll go back to our banner ad that we did, and we'll put some animation in there, and we'll use this technique, a frame-by-frame animation on that. Or, if we're bringing in video, we can work with a video animation, and notice that the video is all on one layer. We control the video from the animation timeline down here. Let's just get this layer up out of the way, our panel out of the way again. In this case, we can watch the video by using the playhead, just like that. I can control the start and stop of the video. Mark that off with these controls. So I'll just find my start position right there, and I'll pull this into the start position. There we go, it's my start. I'll pull this through to find my ending position, which is just about in there somewhere. Let's see if we can pull this up here, make it a little wider. Stretch that out. There we go. Let's let that kind of finish off in there, and then I can set the end frame, end position right there. So we're now working with this as our video section. We can zoom in or out on our video with this little control here and see the whole range of the video if you want to. Just like that. Whatever is useful for you. We can play through the video. We can stop that. We can step back frame at a time. We can go back to the beginning of the whole video. Step forward just like that. If we're doing any rendering, it's going to be rendering inside of this section in here, the white section on our video. So the two different ways then of bringing video into Photoshop, and two different ways of working with the video once you have the video inside of Photoshop. Again, that's frame by frame, looking at each individual frame of video, and the other way is working with it as a video layer.